The standard Oracle Access Management login pages can be customized to suit your organization's needs. Let's look at how we change the login pages. This is the standard login page. You can customize this page by switching out the graphics files or modifying the JSP. Here, we view the page info for the standard login page. Notice the different graphics files used. We're going to change the login logo and login page background files. Now, let's open the Oracle Access Management console and look at the authentication schemes. We will change the LDAP, Adaptive Authentication and Passwordless Authentication schemes to use new customized login pages. This is the default page for multi-factor authentication using the Adaptive Authentication scheme. We can use the same two graphics files to customize it. This page is used by the passwordless scheme to enable passwordless authentication. The page info shows that the same two graphics files are used. This next page is also part of passwordless authentication and shows that the push notification has been sent. The page info shows the same two graphics files are used here. This last page is used to register devices for both passwordless and multi-factor authentication. The page info also shows the same two graphics files. In order to provide a custom version of the login pages, we first need to create a copy of the OAM Custom Pages WAR file. You can find this file in your middleware home in the OAM Server Tools Custom Pages directory. Next, extract the archive and change into the Images directory. Now replace the two graphics files with your customized versions. Create a new archive with the changed files. This is the WAR file that you deploy using the WebLogic Administration Console. Now that the new customized WAR file has been created, deploy it to the OAM server. Keep track of the context that you deploy the WAR file to. The name of the deployment defaults to the same name as the WAR file. This is your new custom context. Once the WAR file is deployed and running on the OAM server, update the authentication schemes to point to the new context. Whilst editing the LDAP authentication scheme, note that the challenge URL contains the path to the login page that is used for this scheme. The context value and the challenge URL are combined to provide the redirect to the login page. In our case, the default context of OAM changes to Acme Pages for a login page URL of Acme Pages, Pages, login.jsp. Next, we change the adaptive authentication scheme the exact same way. The context type is now custom WAR and the context value is Acme Pages. Then, change the passwordless authentication module to update the context used for the passwordless.jsp page. This page is where the user can choose to enable passwordless authentication. To change the default context for the device registration page, we use curl to make a call to the QR service endpoint. This call changes the custom web route setting from the default value of OAM to Acme Pages. Now that all the changes are done, let's take a look at the customized login pages. We first look at passwordless authentication. The user sees the login page with our new images and logs in. Note that we used a transparent PNG for the login logo graphic and a full screen graphic for the login page background. They now have the option to enable passwordless authentication. This page also uses the same two customized graphics files. The next time that the user logs back into the protected page, they see that a push notification has been sent. Here we see a page for multi-factor authentication. The user selects the second factor authentication method. This next page is our new customized device registration page. The logout page can be accessed either by using the custom context path to the logout JSP page or by passing an end_URL query parameter to the standard logout path. And that's it. We've just customized the Oracle Access Management login pages. Learn more at oracle.com/security.